whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. So welcome to you who are joining us online. When everything around us is changing and is unchanging, he is always good, always, and he has been promised to be close to the brokenhearted. So let's take a moment to be still. In the name of Christ, remember George. We come with sorrow to express our loss, but also with hope as we give thanks for his life, to recognize his death, but also to celebrate his life, to look back at all that has been, but also to look forward to all that is yet to be. God is here. The God who has promised that in life or in death, he is with us. God gives to all who truly believe the assurance of his eternal presence and blessing. As we begin our service, let us pray. Lord Jesus, you were moved to tears at the grave of your friend Lazarus. Look with compassion on us today in our loss. Give our troubled hearts hope, and strengthen in us the gift of faith. In Jesus' name, amen. We now have our Bible reading.
taken from 1 Corinthians 15, 51, 57. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed in a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound. The dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, when the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable and the mortal with immortality, then they, saying that is written, will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Death is your victory. Death is your sting. The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much. Now the Reverend Sam's going to lead us in our Thanksgiving prayer. Yes, it is.
Let's pray. Most gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we are thankful to you today for helping us celebrate the life of our dear uncle, George Selvarajah, whom we affectionately call Thambi Mama. We will not be sad because he is no longer with us, but we will rejoice because he lived with us. Our hearts are filled with gratefulness for all what you have been to him and all what you have done in his life. You prepared a beautiful life for him when you sent him to this world. Your son Jesus died for him to forgive his sins, to cleanse him with his precious blood, to make him your child and give him an abundant life. We believe that he accepted Christ in his life as Lord and Savior and became a son of God. Father, from the time of his conception in the mother's womb to now, where he has come to live with you, you divinely took care of every moment of his life. You provided for him, protected him, guided him, gave him good health, and made him successful in all areas of life. The joy that he had, the peace that he experienced, and the wisdom that he possessed are all your gifts, precious gifts to him. Thank you for the education, qualifications, and knowledge that he gained because of you. You helped him to come up in life, gave him a successful career, and made him prosperous in every part of his life. Thank you, Lord, for the blessings in his marriage. You gave him a wonderful, godly wife and great God-fearing children. You enabled him and Saruji Aunty to not only bring them up in the knowledge of Christ, but provided them with a great education, ensuring they had the best in life. Father, we thank you for bringing Thambi Mama and the family to this land to bless them more and more. You helped him and Saruji Aunty to have successful careers in this country and enable Krishanti and Hiran to have better education. Thank you, Lord, for bringing Glaston into Krishanti's life, who was a great blessing to Thambi Mama and Saruji Aunty. Thank you for the precious time Thambi Mama had with his two lovely grandchildren, where he got to play with them, advise them, and even help them with their studies. And we know how blessed he felt to experience these cherished moments. We believe that he loved you so much, Lord, and we know that he had great faith in you. We thank you, Father, for we know that all of his prayers will be answered at the right time. Thank you for the opportunity you gave him to serve you in the Mutual Church, Colombo, We believe it was something that must have been really pleasing to you, and we pray you will reward him for all what he had been doing as a believer of Jesus Christ. Mm. Now, Father, we all believe that he has come to live with you. We thank you for the rest that has been promised to the children of God. We believe that we will meet him again one day. Thank you for giving us that living hope in our hearts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you all for coming today. Dear Grandpa, although there are so many more things we wish to say to you, stories we yearn to hear, and laughs we hope to have with you, we'll take this time to say thank you and honour you. Thank you for all the love, blessings and joy you gave us throughout our entire lives. You had such a fun spirit with your loud voice and glorious presence, above all with young people. When we went around on our adventures, we had endless fun. On the occasion that you felt a shopkeeper or salesman was trying to take you for a ride, you would announce yourself as the manager or chairman of the establishment they worked for and introduce us as your assistants, and would have to keep up the act with a serious face until we finally left the shop and we would all laugh together. When we would come back, we would walk through the park or stay in the garden. Every time a plane flew past, you would wave your walking stick to redirect it away from the flight path above your house. I have no doubt that pilots flying into Heathrow are all familiar with the waving man at 44 Ivanhoe Road. Your playful quality also extends to other children. The next door children also grew up with your stories, such as that you had lions and snakes under your bed and would even knock on the door and ask Grandma to see them. You had such an open heart. When I was younger, I remember begging Mum and Dad for a catapult. Despite their reluctance to get me the toy, you heard me. The following Sunday, you presented me with a handmade catapult. Needless to say, it did a lot of damage. However, this last month, whilst I was looking in your cupboard, trying to find a good shirt for you to wear today, I found two other catapults. Immediately, I thought of the catapult you made for me. Grandma then told me that if I had broken or lost it, you had fashioned spares just in case. This was the type of man you were. You gave and gave and didn't expect anything in return.
You were always there for us, through thick and thin, doting on us. I remember when I was learning to write letters in school, I sent you and Grandma an invitation to a camping trip in the living room, and you both came. You bought sweets, head torches, and binoculars for the sleepover. Every time we met you, you always had a gift for us. You spoilt us. Just a passing mention of something I liked resulted in a gift the next time I saw you. You'd always remembered exactly what I wanted and bought it for me. You'd ask us what our homework was at school and then come, having gone to the library yourself to do the research. You'd sit next to us and instruct us how to do the project or essay, and at times even did it for us. I'm grateful for the relationship you had with us. You were the first person I called whenever I was upset, because you'd always tell me what I needed, and a lot of the time you sought it out for me. I could share everything with you, the good and the hard stuff. All these years when I called you, you'd say, "What's up?" and want a breakdown on everything that was going on. When I had to do something important, you'd tell me in the morning that you'll be praying for me the whole day. And in the evening when I called you back, you'd want to know all the details of the conversations that I'd had. You were the best grandpa, and we are proud to be yours. Since you went to be with God, the hardest part for us is trying to figure out who we are without you. You were our compass, guiding us on this earth through every decision. We know you will be there throughout every milestone of our life. When we graduate, when we work, when we get married and have children, we will strive to embody the love and devotion you showed us and make sure your legacy will continue forever. Whilst we cannot hear your voice, we know you will continue to be with us, forever in our hearts and in our minds, in everything we do. We love you, Grandpa.
Well done.
Dada, if you are in the Beloved, then you are constantly encircled by God's favor. Dada, you lived in a bubble of God's favor, and so everyone loved you, listened to you, and received you, and blessed you. I give thanks to God that you enriched each of our lives with your wisdom, your advice, counsel, kindness, and generosity. Your wisdom is a voice that will live in our hearts forever. God, you said, if you ask me anything in my name, I will do it so that the Father may be glorified. Dada, you asked big and you lacked nothing until you took your final breath. You lived your life glorifying God. You never carried a purse. Your pocket was full of cash, and you gave generously to all
as God gave generously to you. You loved us as God loved you. Your thoughtfulness and kindness knew no measure. You taught us how to come together and be united as a family, and your legacy will live on. Dada, you did more for me than I could ever have asked. I am so grateful and proud to be yours. You have gently passed away to the glorious banquet that awaits you. May your soul rest in peace. I love you, Dada.
My earliest memories of my father are all smiles and playful chat, and me following him around to observe him or what he was doing and to learn from him. Yes, undoubtedly he left lasting impression on my life. Dada, you have taught me many principles about life, and I have listened and observed you. I remember the chats after meal times, which was always philosophical and engaging. These precious conversations shaped me and made me who I am today. The life lessons I have learned about service and sacrifice comes from you. You taught me that handling setbacks and failures, well, is as important as success. And most importantly, a principle that I can summarize as dealing with issues in the spiritual realm than in the physical realm. You have been an encourager and supporter of and a key driving force behind many of my life's achievements. And I have many, many special memories of you. The most special to me that I would always treasure is being with you as you made Christ the Lord of your life. It was a privilege and an honor for any child to be part of such a memory. This was not an accident. It had been a year in the planning, and many people praying for that precious moment. And when the day arrived, and it was a beautiful memory of mommy beside you, at the end of the prayer and communion, there was an immense sense of relief and a weight off my shoulders that my primary assignment in life was complete, to see both my parents in Christ. It was a realization that the purpose I was born for was now accomplished. Dada, as I stand here, it's not a goodbye from me to you. And I know this is temporary separation. And I will be seeing you again. On the 10th of March, when Mummy called me to say that Dada had left us, I put the phone down, and my first words were, "Thank you, Jesus, because I know that the Lord had promoted you to glory in the most peaceful way and an answer to my prayer." So I salute you, Dada, for a life well lived, and the lasting impression you left behind on many. And I've been seeing you again, and all is well. Mm.
I'm Gladstone Worthington, son-in-law of late Mr. George Chelvanayagam Selvarajah. I consider this as a privilege to bid farewell to a wonderful human being who lived on earth with us. In all the time I have known you, which is over 3 decades, I have observed the following. Uncle, you worked in the UK as a legal advisor for immigration matters. This involved you interviewing men and women to represent their cases. You carried a briefcase, and in it, among other official stuff, there were Kit Kat chocolates, Mars bars, and carton of soft drinks. During your interview, you casually took them out and shared with your clients. This act eased their pain and brought comfort to them as though they were talking to a friend. You had the gift of logical thinking in legal matters and eloquently presented your words. Your arguments had no loopholes for decision makers and authorities. And so they had no choice other than approving your request. This applied to Home Office matters, local authorities, and even with landlord and tenancy disputes. With these gifts, you helped family, friends, strangers who came to you for assistance. Regardless of their background, there was no difference in the way you treated people. With your famous phrase, I say, you would engage with anyone in our family circle and speak to him or her to make the person feel he or she is very important. We will miss you always, especially at our parties and gatherings, where you worried about everyone else's happiness. You lived your life as the Good Samaritan that the Lord Jesus taught us in the Bible. Never cross the other side of the road to avoid helping a person. You well understood the parable and who is your neighbor. Uncle, every time we gathered in prayer, I have seen tears in your eyes, taking your handkerchief out and wiping both of your eyes. You loved watching country and western films, probably because those were the only films that you could watch without crying. You lived your life according to St. James chapter 2, verses 17. It says, so you see, faith itself isn't enough unless it produces good deeds. It is dead and useless. You lived your faith. You have left us a legacy to cherish and to follow. And I thank the Lord that you lived his plan and purpose of loving and helping others.
Thank you.
We came with nothing into this world and cannot take anything with us when our days are over. The legacy we have behind us is the testimony to our existence. To my knowledge, Thambi Mama is the only one addressed as Thambi Mama by his nephews, nieces, grandchildren, even great-grandchildren. This is a unique title a person can have. It is like calling George King George by everyone. He has his own way of doing things. He even got down the headstone for Amma's grave all the way from Sri Lanka. He is a man with positive thinking and would not give up on anything so easily. He knows all the nooks and corners of London. And if you ask him anything, he will somehow find it for you. Once we went with him to central London to get our Indian visa, and the gate was closed as they were taking only a certain number of people a day. He asked us to wait, went with his famous hat and walking stick, had a chat with the guard at the gate, and we were allowed to go in. In by 2 p.m., we got our visas. What he told him is still a mystery. If perseverance is his middle name, achievement is his last name. During my late teens, I was staying at his house in Mutual, Colombo. His house was always full of people, with fun and laughter. Whenever I go for a job interview, he will carry the typewriter for me all the way to the examination hall. After taking all this trouble, and before I could even got a job, I met my man and the job was a distant memory. His house in Mutwar was our wedding venue in 1979, relations coming from all parts of Sri Lanka. The Christmas parties at the Mutwar house were a yearly event that brought all the family members together. After Saroji Aunty and Thambi Mama bought the house in UK, the tradition continued. There were ups and downs, arguments and disagreements, like in all families, but the fun and enjoyment continued year after year until he was not physically fit to continue. He was a man with a sense of humor. Once we four of us went to the Holy Land, and the guide used to take us out every day in 40 degrees temperature and explain all the ruins and the history of the place. After 2 days, Thambi Mama got fed up and he started his own historical explanation of the sites and the pilgrims. And the pilgrims thought that he was part of the guide group. The guide almost begged him to stop quiet in fear of losing his job. I can still recall the day we all had our baptism renewed at the Jordan River, wearing the white robes, and our marriage vows renewed at the church in Cana after a service for the married couple. I am happy that I was able to cook Pitu and his favorite beef poria during the last few months, which he really enjoyed. He is a man who will not allow anyone to leave his house without a meal. Thambi Mama was blessed with a wife, partner, a companion in Saroji Aunty. She was his support and strength physically, financially, and intellectually in carrying out the day chores of life. Very true to the marriage vow, Saroji Aunty was by his side until his last breath. Thambi Mama has touched many hearts in various ways, and I am one of those, and his memories will linger on for years to come. As is the belief of Christian, he is now in a better place and in the hands of our Creator, which is the ultimate goal of every human being. Life is not a rehearsal, and you have only one chance to live it up. Thambi Mama, you will be in our memories as always, as someone who has set a benchmark for others to follow. Your niece, Nirmala and Kumar. Tambi Mama was someone to look up to, someone to follow, someone to admire, someone to be proud of, someone to learn from, and someone most of all to love. I'm grateful that I can stand here today and tell you that I am blessed to have had him in my life. Tambi Mama has done so much for me and my family. I will eternally be grateful to him. Tambi Mama was very dear to Dada. I remember when Dada was very ill, Tambi Mama, who was then working at Columbus Central Bank, would travel all the way to visit Dada in Jaffna. And he did this on a regular basis. When Dada couldn't work, we didn't have any income. But Tambi Mama always gave Mummy enough money for all our daily expenses. His generosity knew no bounds, and it was a quality admired by many. Dada went straight to Mutuval House when he was discharged from hospital without giving it a second thought, as he knew he would be welcomed by Tambi Mama. And it was there Dada breathed his final breath on Tambi Mama's lap. Tambi Mama continued to look after us even as we grew older. He would call Akka Perusu and me Chinnan. When I got my job in Colombo, Tambi Mama and Sarojini Anta opened their home to stay there while I worked. They did this with Akka too. I remember when he would come home from work, he would call out Perusu Chinnan and ask us to tell him about our day as he enjoyed his dinner. We are so grateful to both Tambi Mama and Sarojini Anta. They took care of both Akka and me until Dada and Mummy moved to Colombo. I will never forget her time with Tambi Mama in that Mutual house. We were blessed to have enjoyed so much quality time with beautiful memories as a result. Mummy was so fond of her Tambi, she would never speak negatively of it. After she had a stroke in 2018, I remember how upset Mama was. And two of them continued inquiring about each other and praying for each other. By God's grace, they got a chance to see each other in January 2020, just before the pandemic. It was the day before Tambi Mama was going to hospital for a procedure. But he insisted on coming all the way to Sutton to see Mummy, as she was not very well. It made Mummy so happy to see him. Tambi Mama was loved, supported, guided, encouraged, and made people laugh. He was kind and compassionate and had the biggest heart. Tambi Mama, you have left a huge void in our lives. We know that you have gone to be in a better place. You are with your Maker in heaven, watching over us, and we know we will meet you again one day. We love you.
Jesus said, believe in God and also in me. My Father, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Then I will come and take you. Where I am, you shall also be with me. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of this earthly life.
We thank you for the life of Selvarajah Anne, for the years you gave him and the character that you shaped in him. We thank you for his life, for every memory of love and joy, for every good deeds and the enjoyment we all shared with him. We thank you for the rest in Christ he now enjoys. We thank you for giving Selvarajah to us for a time. And we praise you for the glory we shall share together for eternity. God of peace, as we end this time of gathering and bid our last farewell to our dearly departed loved one, we ask for your comfort upon every person who are here, especially Saurajee Machal, Krishanti, Hiran, Helena Luke, and Gladstone, and all the nieces and nephews, and all those who have joined us through this live streaming from other parts of this world, especially Chandraka, Shanti, over in Sri Lanka, and here Akka, Lali, and all the people in Australia, Canada, and the other parts of UK. Be with them each and every day. Let them feel your loving and strong presence in their hearts as they adjust to life without Selvarajah. We ask that your spirit will be their constant companion, assuring them of the love and care. Fill their longing and emptiness with your overwhelming love. Let them rest in your faithful care, especially in the coming days and the weeks. God of comfort, let your presence be known to each one who suffers from this pain and this loss. We ask it all in our Lord Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
We now commend George into the loving hands of his loving father, and I'm going to anoint his head with oil. George, I anoint you with oil as a sign that you belong to God. God has welcomed you into his kingdom. Amen. Going to have a blessing here, and then we'll process out and have our commending prayer outside. Shall we stand together? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look kindly on you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with all those who forevermore. Amen. Thank you.
around for our final prayer.
Amen. Amen. Father, we believe that you are pleased with what we are doing. Because we believe, Father, that you are the one who sent the great man of God to this world. And you are the one, Lord, always be with him in everything that he was doing. You gave him a great life. And you are always by his side. Lord, your grace is there upon him all the time. Father, we believe that when we come to you and commit him into your hands, you will be taking care of him. Thank you, Father, today. We want to commit this body into this place. And we believe that one day,
Thank you. I'll take our first scripture reading from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 from 51 to 58, and I read. It says, "Now this I say, brethren, that flesh that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither do corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkle of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruptible, and this mortal must put on immortal. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruptible, and this mortal shall have put on immortal, then shall he brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." Amen. I'll read the second reading, and I'll take it from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18. And I read, "But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words." I'll read the last verse, chapter, then we proceed. John chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. The book of John chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. "Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
To Jesus, I surrender.
We have come to the final hour where Anna will be laid to rest. Heavenly Father, we thank you this day for your precious and eternal and unchanging word. We thank you that you are to us the rock of ages and the great I am. In the midst of our great loss and sorrow, we thank you for the strength, comfort, and grace that you have given us. In the face of death, we thank you for your gift of eternal life. In the face of separation, we thank you for the eternal reunion we so eagerly anticipate. We thank you for our dearly beloved George Selvarajah's life here on this earth. And we recognize that the body that lies before us is not of George Selvarajah, but rather the house in which he lived. We acknowledge that George Selvarajah is rejoicing even now in your very presence, enjoying the blessings of heaven. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. We have entrusted our dearly beloved George Selvarajah into God's merciful keeping, and now we commit his body to the ground, earth to ashes, dust to dust. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to the eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultlessness before the presence of his glory, with exceeding joy to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Amen. Please, if you want to do the last respect, please come forward. Come closer. Come a little bit closer.
Okay, you can come forward.
You know, the Father may fall and with blood as the
in this world, by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In this world,
by and by. We shall meet on the beautiful shore.
We shall see
on the beautiful shore.
And our spirits shall sorrow no more, nor the sight for the blessing of rest
in the soul and by. Beautiful show, what beautiful Father about. We will offer the praise
for the glorious gift of His love.
And then direct them to come and do this. Soon, by and by, we shall be beautiful show. By and by, we shall meet on the beautiful show. In the sweet, by and by, we shall be on the beautiful show.
Guide me, O my great Redeemer, pilgrim through this barren land.
I am weak, but Thou art mighty. Hold me with Thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Feed me till I want no more. Open now the crystal fountain where the healing waters flow. Let the world carry feeler, let me all my journey through. From deliverer, storm deliverer, lives in your strength and shield. Ever be my strength and shield. When I tread the verge of Jordan, bid my anxious fears subside. Death of death and hell's destruction, let me human can hide. Long the praises, long the praises, I will give to Thee. I will ever sing to you.
strong.
Kirubai nirai
தாமதம் மை கண்டடைந்தேன் தேவ சமூகத்திலே என்னை நோக்கி போடு என்னை தோமானே ரத்திலும் என்னை நோக்கி கோடு என்னை தோமானே ரத்திலும் கருத்தாய் விசாரித்தேன் கனிவோடு என்னை நோக்கிடுமே கருத்தாய் விசாரித்தேன்
Oh, my grandparent. I have grandparents and I grew up. Oh, you want to have a walk on one.
Oh, my God.
I'm taking a chance to come back and do the right button. I'm going to go to the right one. I'm going to go to the
right
one. I'm going to
back. I had to collect the microphone from the both of them. No, I'm gonna do it. Do you want me to do it now?
Uh-huh.
Just give me 1 second. I'll go on quickly grab it. Oh, sir.
Father Lord, I want to thank you. I want to give you praise. I want to give you glory. Lord, we thank you for everything that you have done. And every one of us here, and I pray that may your countenance be risen upon us and give us your peace as we go back to our respective places. Lord, I pray for your divine covering and your divine protection upon each and every one of us. We declare your blessing upon each and every one of us, and Lord, I pray that may you continue to strengthen us in these difficult times. We thank you and we give you praise. Now may the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you. May he be gracious unto you, and may his face shine upon you, and may his countenance be risen upon you, and give you his peace. I declare that you are blessed and highly favored. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Take this stand up. Yeah. Or we're gonna take this one also.
You know what, Daniel? My battery is finished here. You mm-hmm. don't believe. Where is the new car? You don't believe that black suitcase.
Suitcase?
Yes, you know the black one. Before you put the microphone, the power bank. You know that black suitcase, small. It's like in the back. No, I need your battery for this.
Sure, right. Okay, let me do it. There's a, in the box, there's a four gray black batteries there.
Yeah, you know that they pocket.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
We have a second one of this one, like soft one.
Like a battery you're looking for, right?
Yeah, I'm looking for this battery. For this one.
Alright, okay, I know.
It's there inside. You see this one?
Yeah, I know, the Russell battery.
Yeah, yeah, it's there inside. It's inside. Oh. The name is car.
Yeah, it's Sam day off, you see?
I don't know how come she manages.